Hey everybody, it's Dan, back with another episode of Megabase version 2. Last couple episodes we built our first train and we created our first science. We had a starter science that kind of over around here, taking the first bits of copper and iron from these smelters to do our basics early green and red science, but since then we created real green and red and military science. We're still, you know, not really doing a ton of that quite yet, but our goal this episode is to start refining, and then from there and having a whole lot of yelling noisy kids outside. So they're having fun and we're having fun indoors, and they're yelling probably in Spanish and I can't understand Spanish, so, or they're just being loud and I, or you know, yelling stuff. So we're gonna put the refinery over here. This is where it's gonna be, because this is where water is, but the oil's not here, so we're gonna have to mine it here. So we're gonna need a loading platform here. We're gonna need a track up and over, and then bring a train in here, and then process here. So let's grab some bullets. I was creating, you know, the episode screenshots and uploading blueprints and so forth to Factorio Prince, and we had a bunch of biters come in and start chewing on my base. So I'm gonna actually spend a couple minutes creating some defenses. Obviously not going to be all end all of this. So I'm just holding control and right click over those, and quite possibly those biters will come in through here and we'll just have to do something about that. Okay, so we have very minimal iron even though we got full iron here, so we also, so we can do something about that since we added new iron to our, well, we added a second mining iron input facility. Since we added, you know, iron from train, we actually have a lot of extra iron ore coming to our base. So we can begin migrating this down line. All right, so one of the things we can begin with is I don't think I have it there. We have a 4x4 splitter in there. Yes, we do. Some of that going. And so we're going to output priority right. So you know, the ore on the inside here will not be used first. We'll always, if we can, try to offload from there. And then if we don't have enough, okay, so like I said, we're probably not going to have proper defenses. I kind of hoped we would, but you're chewing on my base. Pet biters. And don't show my bots, please. Thank you. Problem is, my bots don't actually fix anything or replace. Ugh, they're up here too. Wow, okay. That. Where else are they killing me? I don't see what died up here. Something died, it seemed like. Just objects being damaged. So when I did my first playthrough of this, my initial base, they really kind of left me alone. So was kind of expecting more of the same. It's okay, we can deal with them. Some of this. I was really hoping to get my lasers going before they started being a real pain. Lots and lots of bullets. Alright, so how's this iron flow doing down here this way? Alright, we're back to full. Get this research out of the way. So how are we on belts and stuff? Yellow belt we don't need. We do need to guns, and we also need to create mining upper pump checks. That's the word I'm looking for. Check. Pipe or underground pipe. This needs iron. so well, let's get our solar going here. Let's also need steel gears and circuits. Stack two. I think 10. I know chem plants are 10. We might as well do chem plants while we're thinking of it. That's pretty much the same exact same thing as this guy. I can't get steel right there. I have to do some ugliness. Let's research landfill. Probably ought to be able to get that pretty fast. So how are we doing on pump jacks? I'm gonna need, just give me a count, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15, 16, 17. Alright, we're working on solar. Stack to 50. Let's do that. These only stack to 10, so we probably don't need so many to start with. turrets. Let's reload. Let's. Gray science doing it. Alright, totally backed up. This should be flowing grenades, right? It's only showing 10. Hey, Humble Constructs. It's really just a couple bare blueprints. Let's send that through this. Just a couple laser blueprints. One for kind of early game, and then one as I ramp up on lasers and don't really have to worry about having enough. Alright, so I don't have any of this. I guess we can do armor. We don't need it yet, but we can do it. How are we doing on items here? Grab more grenades. Do we have our 17 infected? Exactly 17. Grab some pipes. Guess we can start working towards that. Oh, we're gonna need, we need storage tanks. I guess we can hand make those. I mean, it's not terribly hard. Let's storage tanks take pipe if I remember. And then we're gonna want storage tanks don't take pipe. What about train tankers? Yes. Right, so some storage tank, fluid wagons. Hey, you know what? Let's do that guy over there in case we do want something with those pipes. Steel in. some more things to research. Yeah. Right, what's a while, Humble? Like months, years? I mean, I was on vacation for 4 weeks. I barely played, but I finally just broke down. I use a side keyboard, and it actually requires the internet connection. I just broke down and started using my regular keyboard. It's hardly enough. I think we might have to come back for those. We're going to need a bunch of those, though. Let's just hand make a bunch. Faster. We'll just have to pick up more supplies, which is not a problem. I think we also need more bullets. So take all those. Okay, we are jammed full, but we can get rid of some stuff. Need more wood products on us now. I guess we can do a whole research stone walls. Look how fast that goes. Bam. Gates. How's this coal doing? We're gonna have to upgrade it. Looks like. Been chewing. You know, the best defense in Factorio are actually trees. Biters just get all confused because of trees. I won't add flammables at the moment. One thing we do need to know. See how they come in the trees, like, they don't even approach. Well, they did approach a little bit, but trees really offer great defense. Looks like we need a few more guns in here, though. Is, but what's going on here? I put priority left. Oh, that's because I rotated that. Okay. Alright. Alright, so the best way to do this is not to link them all together. There's 17 divided by 3 is not an even number, so 17, 18 divided by 3 is what? Actually, not divided by 3, divided by 4. It's really 16, so 4 plus 1 would be 5 for one of them. I'm going to have a track. We're going to need engines, and I'm not carrying any. In fact, I don't think I set a chest to collecting engines. I'll have to come back for that. Well, this coal's not really backing up. Right, and see, these aren't doing anything. Could is be collecting some engines. Too bad. Now we can take those for those, because we're going to need some pumps and a bunch of them. Pumps are easy to handcraft, so I don't terribly worry about having enough. Or I mean, have them automated. Shoot. Would have been nice to have those done. How many of these do we got? Right, that should be sufficient. We do need four fluid wagons. Let's start with those. We got 5 train engines on us. That's probably sufficient. Let's see what else we can research here. Circuits, bullets. Now let's top off this one stack. Silly of me to leave these all unprotected. Eventually I'm going to be tapping this copper, so I might as well just stick the defenses around it. Should have grabbed more ammo. In fact, we're just going to rip up some of these. Right. little bit of defense there. Mostly attack will come from the right. Okay, so where'd my pipe book go? Stick it there. Do we have one extra? Thought I counted 17 when I did this, but I'm not seeing one of these without a pump jack on it. So for these, let's go get more bullets. As you can see with Big Science, we get, you know, all this stuff done pretty quickly. There, we're going to be running short, but I think we'll be sufficient because we'll soon be pull up these turrets. Soon be making lasers, what I'm trying to say. Alright, so we need to put down our train now. And we can offshoot some coal this way. This blueprint. Alright, then the way these are going to line up. Thank you. almost done with research. Oh no, I see some great science that could be done. Let's do that. Alright, so what did I say? Four. One of these will get five. Should maybe I'll grab some more pipe. So that's four of them. Then let's do those two and these three. Not the prettiest of design. Since I did that, it would merge that way. And that's, can't do that. We can't send it this way, it's because we already have an underground pipe there. Well, we can suppose. Five, so we should have four. I miscounted, so we only had 16. So almost dead. Go pretty well, like right there, but is going to power that. Once we get substations, this will be a little easier to power. Okay, so the advantage of what I did is that this flows, these flow into this and kind of flow down. If you put them all into one network, the pipe can only hold so much. So each one of these are flowing directly into, or well, not each, but each sort of group is flowing directly into a tank. And they can, all these pumps can be working. That's the advantage of that design. All right, so how many pumps do I have left? I do have enough pumps. There we go. We are going to need some rail signals now, though. I guess I'll have to do it there. A little bigger block than I'd want. Yeah, we don't really need that. This will just all be one big block. Only one train can be in there at a time. Let's run over some biters. Come on, spitters. Get on the track. Come on, you can do it. guns. Except this is part of the coal. Oops. Don't go after my bots, please. Thank you. Last time I set it down to about right there, but turns out I wanted it a little further south, so I'll do about right there. Because spiders can show up at any time. Let's not build a too many bot-built track. Got some grenades, but I don't want to blow up valuable track with them. Where's my guy? Research into grenade damage, you can just do one of these per throw. Kind of want to leave some of these trees for defense. Trees will heal. If you leave them alone. Any more grays? Hey, laser turrets. All right, let's bring this down a little further. Let's go get our train before it's killed by biters. Can I get a station though? This is gonna be to the station so you line up things properly. We're going to do basically the same thing we did with loading to unload. A little harder to line these up when they're backwards, but we can just rotate these. All right, we need more engines. Then we're gonna wanna move. We got a whole bunch of miners we can pick up here. Extra pump jack, let's just there. Top off guns. Pipes. Got a bunch. And we're gonna need a bunch when we start setting down refineries. For pumps, or really for engines. Just grab a stack. Start with. new one. Some grenade damage. Not gonna really be able to get grenade damage 4, which we need, which I was talking about. Let's see, we need 4 and 4. About one of the mods I'm using. I can actually put power poles on water. Boom. I forgot to put a radar down in this area. So we can do our first set of refinery. Go with my early game build. It won't be exactly this. In fact, we're gonna need some stone. Make our refineries. I'm doing my bullets. I'll use them. Let's just need a kind of a walkway up to this new refinery area. Don't want this set up here, Dink, so let's remove it. Let's create our 3 refineries. Actually, we want 7, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Switch to automatic. It doesn't fill with crude or advanced. It doesn't fill with crude oil. So, the advantage of doing what we did here is, it's too bad this off by just one, is that we get a full pipe of oil coming to it. Full pressure is what I'm saying. So then we're going to need, how are we doing on these? Let's start by doing these over here. We're going to need heavy oil and so forth. So this. And we're going to want a rhythmic combinator. Need some more circuits. Take that and put that to there, and then I'll put it to the. So when we look at power poles in the general vicinity, we'll know how much we have on hand. We'll take each, we'll divide it by 750. It's 250 per tank, and we'll output each. So each thing will get divided by 750 and output its name. Great, so. That. And petroleum there. Now we'll actually temporarily ahead of time need some extra. Heavy oil, light oil. But let's take a pile of you guys. We can start by can't. Thinking of putting it into there, but that actually turned out to be a bad idea. Because that's the output, not the input. This could be moved later. Nothing's permanent. Okay, so we can see. We got 12 petroleum, 9 light oil, and 8 heavy oil. That's in percentage. So that's how full these series of tanks are. Okay, we're going to need sulfuric acid. For that, we're going to need water. So sulfuric acid is sulfur. It's really 5 sulfur to make 1 sulfuric acid. So we will do a 2-to-1 setup. So sulfur looks like that. So we have petroleum and then sulfuric acid. So ideally we want a setup that can be beaconed and all sorts of stuff, right? So we need 3 spaces for a beacon, because a beacon is the size of a assembly machine. So to get beacons in here, we would need that much space. So we do this. Sulfur. So this one needs to be water and this one needs to be petroleum. Same thing with beacons. We need 3 spaces. So I'll put it to a chest and then input it to same water supply. If I go there, I won't be able to put the beacon right there. So we can't do that there. But we could. I'll leave that alone. Though having these underground pipes without anything connecting to them. Kind of dangerous. We could get contamination going. Well, we could bring in other water or something. Or for the moment use. Is it? That one works, but this one doesn't. So iron. Oh, we need iron, right? Iron. I need to bring a bit of iron. Could go with that. Let's see here. If we did. That's horrible. Some sulfuric acid, good. this way for light oil. So what we'll do, we'll just do something like that, because this is gonna overflow at some point. We just simply won't be able to keep up until we get some advanced oil going. All right. I'm gonna go add this radar down here, and then I will call this an episode. This was refining, getting oil onto train up to offload, and then some basic refining. This is all the basic oils from lubricant or heavy oil, light oil, petroleum, and sulfuric acid. These will come out when one tank is full. It's 100% pressure. That's why to use pumps. If you had it all three, kind of like these guys are, if you had the same, if you only had 200 or say 25K as this is, spread through that, then would it be at 33% pressure instead of full pressure? Got any burnables while I'm staying there? Nope. So you can see this is starting to dwindle. That's why it's good to have the train. This will go away after some point. Mostly once we get electric miners going, which is purple science. Alright, so where's the right spot for you? Somewhere about there. Get some repairs going. Good. So by using lighted poles, we have all this lit up. That's what I like about this lighted electric poles mod. So, you know, you got all this where I have them put anyways. The lights. It's a neat mod. Don't have to have separate lights everywhere. I don't know if I'd highlighted that before in the series, so it's good to have. Anyways, I could go flammables. I guess I do need it for rocket shooting speed to get rocket silos, so I guess we can start working on that. Next episode, we will work on getting red circuits, and then blue science, well, red circuits, and actually what we can start with is laser turrets. So we'll need batteries. And do we need batteries for lasers? Yes, I believe we do. Yes, batteries. So we'll need batteries, and that's what we can use our sulfuric acid for. And we'll do batteries down here, plastic down here. Leave us room to expand. We'll do red circuits down here. And then we'll be able to do blue science. Rockets, we need explosives. Alright, so thanks for watching. If you like what you're seeing and like to see more, follow me on Twitch or subscribe on YouTube. Thanks for watching. I'm Toon, and I'll catch you next time.